Piscitelli here, trade analyst at ICHAM, the Italian Chamber of Commerce in Vietnam. With this video, we are proud to launch our third mini-series, this time focusing on another important agreement, the RCEP. What is this RCEP about? Well, the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership is one of the largest free trade agreements in the world. After 8 years of negotiation, it was signed on November 15, 2020, and on its entry in force, it will cover 30% of the world population and GDP, accounting for almost 28% of the world trade. The countries involved in this economic partnership are the ASEAN member states, Australia, China, Japan, New Zealand, and South Korea, for a total of 15 countries. The RCEP creates a new trade framework for the signatory countries, laying the foundation for a homogeneous and regulated international trade system. Defined as the first move in the post-COVID-19 world, the RCEP regulates trade between countries by establishing standardized rules of origin and regulating the reduction of custom tariffs, trade in service, investments, and protection of intellectual property. As ICHAM, we always work to support both Italian and Vietnamese companies to increase their business opportunity. While obviously the latter will greatly benefit from this economic partnership, it should also be noted that Italy will greatly benefit in terms of advantages with its EU competitors. As shown, in fact, with other FTAs signed by both Italy and other Asian countries, Italian small and medium enterprises have been the ones that benefited the most from a homogeneous framework compared with other EU firms. Back to the RCEP, let's talk about tariff barriers. This will be eliminated for the great majority of articles within 25 years from the entry in force of the RCEP. Despite the common framework, however, signatory countries have different timescales for clearing entry duties of traded goods. Plus, it is also important to remember that not all tax-free articles for one country will be necessarily tax-free for another one. What does it mean? Considering the heterogeneity of the tariff regime that each single country has with another state, it is understandable to face such discrepancies. To give you an example, Japanese tariffs on shellfish imported from ASEAN countries will be tax-free within 60 years from the entry in force of the agreement, while there are no indication that such reduction will apply also for shellfish imported from South Korea. Considering the notable amount of differences, in this mini-series we will talk about the several reduction for the Vietnamese custom, as well as the reduction of tariffs for article exported by Vietnam. Thus, for further detail, don't miss our future video on this topic. In this one, however, I'm going to talk to you about the general rules of origin made to determine the nationality of a certain article and that will apply for every country in the RCEP. The new system divides article by different categories. The ones whose origin is easy to determine are the goods classified as wholly obtained, such as live animals, fuel, and other indirect materials, all referring to just one country. If not wholly obtained, an article must have a regional value content of not less than 40%. To give you an example, let's take a look at this car. Its engine may be Japanese, its tires may be French, but if at least 40% of all the components are made in Vietnam, this car is considered a Vietnamese car for all the country in the RCEP. Finally, categories like CC, CTH, and CTSH individuate all non-originating materials used in the production of the good, which have been subjected to a change in tariff classification either at a 2, 4, or 6-digit level in the harmonized system. By implementing such rules of origin, there will be a reduction in custom checks and time, letting trade among countries grow even further. That's all for this video. For further details, we invite you to check out our other video on the RCEP and its implication for the Vietnamese market. If you're also interested in doing business between Italy or Vietnam, please contact us to these email addresses and don't forget to subscribe for new economic updates for Vietnam.
Welcome to ICHAM channel. The Italian Chamber of Commerce in Vietnam, ICHAM, is an agency that brings a bigger business network of the Italian company and the Vietnamese company, and also providing a customized experience and services to the company. Services of ICHAM are divided in following main categories. The first one and the most important one is market entry services. The second category is providing the consultancy for investment. The third category is organizing business networking. So if you have any requests or for further detail, please contact us. We are here to help. Thank you. Xin chào và hẹn gặp lại.